In the beginning of this MOOC, we met Hans. Hans sometimes lies about his age. Now, being 68, he doesn't claim to be 38, but he hides his age a little bit. He avoids to disclose it. Or he would make statements like, he has well past 60 now. And again, Hans is not an exception. Many older people deduct a few years every now and then. Kwaku also lies about his age, but he doesn't deduct years, he adds 10 or 20 years. In Ghana, you can boast with your age. Being old is cool in Ghana. And this was a bit of a strange surprise to me in the beginning. You see, in the Netherlands, working with older people is something you have to do as a social service, or something they make young criminals do as a punishment for petty crimes. The nice thing is that in Ghana, it was the first time I could boast about being a doctor specialized in older people. In the Netherlands, most doctors want to become a cardiologist or a surgeon, and a career in geriatrics is not very popular. In Ghana, old age comes with status. You can become a member of the board of elders who advise the chief on all sorts of matters. Old people have a privileged position in society. They are the first to be greeted when you arrive somewhere. They are the one to receive any gifts you bring, etc. Now, the most important social gatherings in Ghana are funerals. For 3 days, people mourn, sing, dance and drink at the same time. They also print t-shirts in a nearby town to commemorate the deceased person. And my colleague Dr. Hans Meij, one of the initiators of the study in Ghana, collected such a t-shirt as a souvenir. Here's a picture of that shirt. In loving memory of Mary Opuku, aged 147. This is not just a great souvenir for a research department trying to unravel the secrets of aging. It's also a testimony to the position older people can have in society, if society permits them to participate. Being active, in good health and connected to a large network of social connections helps. This MOOC explored how the environment can help us to live longer, happier and healthier lives. And let us hope that we can all grow old a little bit more like Kwaku. A first start is to identify all the obesity nudges and health nudges from our environment. So please contribute and collect them in your place and share them with us. Finally, while we try to improve our environment to grow old more like Kwaku, let us at the same time make an effort to give Kwaku's grandchildren an environment that provides them with some of the opportunities that our children have. Only then we will truly have the best of both worlds. This brings us to the end of our MOOC. I thank you for your participation. Please tell us what you thought of this MOOC, and if you like it, spread the word.